We begin to draw to a conclusion here at the Conference USA basketball tip-off event. We are excited to be joined by League Commissioner Judy MacLeod on the program. Commissioner, thanks for taking some time out of your schedule.
You bet, Noah. Thanks for having me.
Well, Commissioner, you are in the midst of your 10th season at the helm of this conference. I know this is a big question, but when you think back over the last 10 years, what are you most proud of when it comes to the progress that the league has made?
Yeah, one of the things that I think gets lost a lot of times is, just the focus on the student athletes. And I think we've done a great job through transitions, maintaining that focus and making sure our student athletes feel like they have a voice in the system. And then just growing our programs. You know, I think our schools work together. Obviously, they're going to compete on the field of play, on the court. But they've really done a great job of trying to do what's best for the whole. And that, you know, when you go through transition, that's not always an easy thing. And so we're really proud of that.
Now, one of the things I think CUSA fans are most excited about has been all of the linear opportunities to watch their favorite teams compete. And thinking back to last season, the partnership with CBS and ESPN, over 30 games airing on linear networks. Judy, how much have those partnerships meant to this league and just in terms of continued exposure?
Yeah, last year was the first year of our new media deals with CBS and ESPN, and the ability for our fans to find our games easily and know that if it's not on linear on one of those places, it's going to be on ESPN Plus has just been huge for us. The exposure that the linear games have given to this league, it helps us educate who's in the league and you know, all of the positive stories that we have. So those have been really important, especially to our fan base.
I really enjoyed the broadcast of the championship game. Found myself flipping on CBS to watch those and thought it was just a great showcase for the league. Now, Judy, in terms of realignment, there's a lot of excitement about the teams that came into this league last year, the Liberties of the world, the Sam Houstons, Jacksonville State. And this year you add Kennesaw State in the future, Delaware and Missouri State. How excited are you about the future of where Conference USA is heading?
You know, we're thrilled with the makeup of our league. And you know, we had a president's call last week and just talked about, you know, we really made the right decision on bringing the members that are in the league now in. And you look at year one for those four, and all of them excelled in certain sports. And so they're coming in competitive. I know Kennesaw's ready to go. And everybody has some growing pains when they enter a new league. But we're really looking forward to that. And adding Delaware and Missouri State is going to be huge for us as well.
Now, ultimately, postseason opportunities are what matter. That's what you and your staff are always pushing for, more opportunities for your student athletes. Last year, we saw Western Kentucky compete in the men's tournament, Middle Tennessee State competing and having a lot of success on the women's side. From your standpoint, what is the conference doing to create more postseason opportunities and greater opportunities for your teams?
Yeah, scheduling, especially the non-conference, is super important. And it's hard because a lot of times, it's hard for us to get home games against quality opponents. And so trying to help our schools scheduling, we did a partnership with the WAC last year, and then that will continue this year. But finding other leagues that we can give our schools quality non-conference games is really important. Trying to help them with MTEs and other opportunities where they might be able to play a great opponent on a neutral floor is also important. So Clifton Douglas handles our basketball and works really hard on scheduling, trying to set some parameters with our leagues to just improve in that area, understanding that scheduling is just, it's not an easy and exact science.
Yeah, that's completely fair. And I found myself looking ahead to some of those games on the calendar in that WAC challenge and a lot of exciting matchups upcoming this season. Commissioner, sticking on the postseason, you know, line of questioning here. Last year, the conference competed in Huntsville for their championship game. I had a chance to be a part of that. It was such a great event. And I have to imagine you guys are extremely pleased with the partnership with the city of Huntsville.
Yeah, year one was great, but we feel like there's a lot of things that we can get better and build on. You know, we've really tried to get out in their community. We have a new program called the Stars of Tomorrow, where we'll have two students from not student athletes necessarily, but two students from each campus come to Huntsville during that time to meet with the business leaders and help their Chamber of Commerce with, you know, workforce growth and bringing quality individuals into their community to work and contribute. And so we think it's a great start, and we're going to try to find a number of ways to partner with their community to get them really involved.
Definitely looking forward to being back there in Huntsville and what is actually just a few short months away at this point. But Commissioner, we're just 20 days away from the return of Conference USA basketball. When you look ahead to this season, what has you most excited?
Yeah, a couple of things. I think I would be remiss if I didn't bring up that the NCAA's, well, it has to go to a final vote in January, but most likely going to award units now for women's basketball. And so we're excited about that opportunity. You know, these days with the transfer portal, sometimes teams look entirely different and it's hard to tell, but we've got a lot of our great players coming back. All of the women on the preseason all-conference team were all-conference last year, so they are all returning. And on the men's side, I think 6 out of 10 as well. And so when you see that, you know, a lot of our quality returning, you look at how Middle Tennessee has performed on the women's side, and they continue to get great opportunities to schedule in the non-conference, and really bringing up our entire women's side with some great teams. You know, FIU had a breakout year last year. Liberty, obviously, is our runner-up. So I look at a player like, and I probably shouldn't just single out one player, but Daniel Bacho from Louisiana Tech. I mean, he's a huge returner for us, and there are many more on the men's side as well. So I'm really excited about just the quality as our teams continue to build. I think last year was a little new for everybody, kind of feeling everybody else out. But this year, I think we're going to see some great action on the floor.
Well, no doubt a lot of quality players in this league and a lot of excitement coming up in the months ahead. Commissioner, thank you so much for your time. Best of luck throughout the year, and look forward to watching some Conference USA hoops.
Thanks, Noah. Appreciate it.